Hello, I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic, and in this video we are going to explore what to expect from taking photos with a Xiaomi Redmi Note 14 Pro Plus 5G. We'll take a quick look together at about 200 photos taken in different places and situations. And we'll explore how this phone differs from its more expensive rivals and how significant those differences are. What you'll see in this video. First, we will summarize the main technical specifications of this mobile phone and what lenses, sensors, functions, and key settings it has. Then, we'll take a closer look at various important features, including portrait, zoom, as well as shooting in a number of extreme conditions. All this using examples of 200 photos from several weeks of detailed testing. I suggest we start with the overview of lenses and sensors. The most important one, of course, would be the main one. It has 23mm and 200 megapixels, which is quite important because, of course, 200 megapixels means that that lens and sensor would be the key tool of that mobile phone. And you can see some examples, and I have to admit I was quite surprised in conditions like that where the results are really, really nice. We'll see some more details, but we can say it even now that that mobile phone is really good at night shooting, as you can see here. Some more examples, Prague in February, and a couple of details in low light, and normal shots, colors, coffees, and portraits. We'll see some more details of portraits. The second lens, of course, is the ultra wide. Let's see some of the examples here. Again, the Swan and Charles Bridge, and very typical usage of ultra wide when we want to squeeze as much of the space around us into the frame here in the streets of Prague or here at the official launch of the Xiaomi Redmi Note. So you won't be disappointed, certainly. What should be stressed, though, is that that sensor has only 8 megapixels, which you can't really see in examples like that. But once you start studying quality in detail, you might be able to see some differences. So to a certain extent, that might be one of the limits of that affordable mobile phone. For instance, Xiaomi 14T has 12 megapixels on that ultra-wide lens, and you can feel it sometimes. And then we have the third lens, third sensor, which is for macro photography, and you can see that you can play with that, but please do not forget it has only 2 megapixels, and it's a limitation, because if you studied those shots more carefully, you probably could still like them, but you wouldn't be able to find many details because 2 megapixels, well, it's simply maybe for sharing on Instagram, but not for printing, for instance. One of really nice features is the ability to turn on shooting to 200 megapixels. We know that the main sensor has 200 megapixels. Of course, under normal circumstances, we are not using it, but you can turn it on. And it could be useful, for instance, in a situation when you really, really want to record a lot of details. And it does indeed work quite nice. You can see we are really in a big distance. And if you take details from the shot, it's quite, from a technical perspective, quite amazing. What I think would be more important for you is the portrait mode, which is quite a typical part of any mobile phones over the last years. So let's see what can we expect here. These are examples from the Prague's launch of this mobile phone. And as you expect, we are able to turn on and turn off these effects and alter how the final photo will look. And again, I believe that you just will not be disappointed because these shots are really, really nice. One important feature to test is zooming. We know that there is no telephoto lens, so the zooming is done from the main sensor with the main lens. And of course, all the zooming is digital one. And well, you can see it here. I can show you some examples. This would be the ultra wide, and we can go from 0.6 to 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we can zoom up to 30, where obviously the quality goes down. And from my tests, from my observation, I would say that probably zooming up to 10 is still all right, but if you go to 20 or even 30, then the quality goes down dramatically. So I think it's up to you to test it on your own if you want to use it. One more interesting example, very tough night conditions, birds and the Charles Bridge and the Vltava River in the heart of Prague. And that would be quite a typical case when we just want to take some nice shots and we are not sure how much can we do digital zooming. So let's try it. There are birds and we are now around 10 and it's all right. And I think 10 or 12, again, is really something which can be used. The quality is not exciting, of course, but if you need that just for maybe sharing on Instagram or just showing to your friends, you probably find that acceptable. Once we stopped here in the Prague under these amazing lighting conditions, let's see one more bird. It's a swan here in the Vltava River, just in the front of Charles Bridge. And I am going very quickly. I apologize for that. Sometimes you are critical and you are writing to me, please do not go that quickly. We just want to have some more time to see what you are showing to us. But I'm really sorry. I just want to show you as many examples as I can. And the point here is that although that mobile phone is really affordable, if you know how to use it, you're able to achieve quite good results, as you can see from that tough light and beautiful river. If I just turn right to the same swan, I know it's really boring, and this time we won't test the mobile phone much on these beautiful creatures because, to be frank, that shots are just much, much nicer. Some more photos from that beautiful part of Prague. One more example of really extreme conditions is obviously night. I love night photography and I love to test mobile phones under that tough conditions. And as you can see from these shots, you again will not be disappointed because I think the results are really nice. And Xiaomi was actually claiming and suggesting in its press materials that the night mode and night shooting should be really improved. And I have to say again that these are results which are nice. And once more, let me stress that no of these shots was edited. All these shots are taken directly from the mobile phone, no editing, no filters, nothing like that. So Prague in so-called blue hour. It might be a good idea to leave the freezing streets of Prague and go inside to test the low-light photography here during the launch of that mobile phone, some electromobiles and details. And once again, all these shots are cropped or are zoomed in digital zoom. So typically you should be afraid that the quality would be going down. Indeed it does, but still it's really good. And you should not be afraid to use it and expect quite decent results. And bit of magic, a magician is showing some tricks with fire, and the mobile phone again proves it's capable of quite interesting things. And some more examples of photos, very ordinary one in the positive sense. If you are lucky that the colors are bright and you are walking through the streets of Prague and there is a lot of sunshine and beautiful clouds, you just will not be disappointed. A lot of colors and something what I called ordinary life, ordinary shooting, which is important because that's what people do most of the time. So that shots should not impress you that much, but to show you what you should expect from that mobile phone once you go to the streets of, say, Prague. Of course, these shots are beautiful and I like them. And again, I have to say that given the price of that phone, well, not bad at all. And my favorite view of Prague. And since I was frozen, a couple of shots from a cafe and once again, colors and shadows and coffee and many details. Some more photos from Prague, Vltava River, Charles Bridge, famous trams and quite ordinary shots, which again are important to see. As I already mentioned, there are some limits. This is, for instance, the ultra-wide lens, which we know has 8 megapixels, which is not much. But at the same time, if you do not really need flagship mobile phones, you'll probably like what you get from these shots. Couple of details, couple of lovers, and let's go to the park outside of Prague. February, no snow, but freezing temperatures, so do not expect too much greenery, but still. I quite like that part of Prague, I love it, to be precise. So I suggest we close that review by shots from these fantastic locations outside of Prague and trees in the mountains of Moravia. So that was the very quick overview of what to expect from photography. And as usual, a couple of examples of video recordings. I am really not good at all in reviewing video capabilities of mobile phones, so the only thing I can do is exactly what I am doing now. So I am showing you some examples and letting you to decide if you like them or not. One important note should be stressed that mobile phone offers recording up to 4K, which is not automatic. Sometimes the companies are tempted to turn off 4K for that range of mobile phones. It did not fortunately happen here, so you can record up to 4K. So thank you so much for your attention. I hope I gave you some inspiration. Take care. I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic.